Tiffany here with Years of Years, and it's another This Day in Disney, May 18th. And today we're going to start off talking about Fred Shields. He was born in 1904 in Kansas City, Missouri, and he was a narrator and voice actor for the Walt Disney Company. He actually narrated in 1942 Saludos Amigos, and then in 1944 the Three Caballeros. He was the voice of Bambi's father, the great prince of the forest. So that's something I'm sure you guys have all heard, his voice. And it's an iconic moment in the film when Bambi's father finally speaks. And so that's Fred Shields. But you will know his voice because he narrates so much for the Walt Disney Company, like the cute shorts, like How to Play Baseball, How to Play Football, How to Play Golf. Just go watch them. They're all on Disney Plus. And when you hear his voice, it's just the way he narrates the material. It's hilarious because it's so straightforward and so, you know, normal and such a great voice. But then the activity happening by the cartoon characters like Goofy or Donald or whatnot are just so funny to be narrated by this, you know, straight face, I guess, straight man, but it's just a narration, if you get what I mean. So it's really, really fun. He's a great narrator. I've enjoyed him. And so he was born on this day. Next up, in 2009, Wayne Allwine passed away. And he passed away at the age of 62. Which I think is kind of young, actually. 62, we should all hope we can make it to, well, I guess I think it's young because my grandmother lived to be almost 100, so I'm shooting for that. But anyway, he was a Disney legend. He was a voice actor, a sound effects editor, and a foley artist, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. But for Walt Disney Studios, he did all of that. He was best known as the official voice of Mickey Mouse. He voiced Mickey Mouse for over 3 decades, and he was one of only 3 people who voiced Mickey Mouse full time. So that's a name you want to remember, Wayne Allwine. And the sweetest thing about this is that he was married to Russi Taylor, or they were married, and Russi Taylor is the voice of Minnie Mouse. So that is just adorable because basically in real life, Mickey and Minnie are married. I just think it's so cute. I love it. And he actually voiced Mickey in the Kingdom Hearts video game, which he did for all of the iterations up until 2014. So his voice was in it, even though he passed away in 2009. So they must have used, you know, stuff from the past. But I thought that was really interesting because it's credited to him on there, on the video games, so for Kingdom Hearts. So I think that's really cool. I think knowing that Mickey's voice translates through movies, cartoons, and video games, it's very fluid and nice that they did it that way. Really good. Another interesting thing about him is that, like I mentioned, he was a foley artist. So if you don't know what that is someone who does sound effects for everyday sounds, like, I don't know, a door slamming or eating your cereal. And one of the movies that he only works on a couple as a foley artist, so it must have just been like an interest to him. But one of them is Frank and Weenie. And I just think it's kind of cool that Mickey Mouse kind of has a tie to Frank and Weenie. Love that movie. That was, you know, one of Tim Burton's originals. So anyway, really fun around Halloween time. But yes, so he did that. So Roy E. Disney said of Wayne that Wayne not only gave voice to Mickey, but gave him a heart and a soul as well. He did an incredible job of bringing emotion, humor, and appeal to the character, and surprisingly carried on the tradition originated by my Uncle Walt, and later by sound effects wizard Jimmy MacDonald. So I'm hoping we'll learn more about Jimmy MacDonald in the future. I'm guessing that's how Wayne's voice is in Kingdom Hearts from 2014. So that's very interesting. But I love Roy's quote, and it just goes to show that even if you're just using your voice and not necessarily the rest of you to voice something, that it has an impact. And he gave a heart and soul to Mickey Mouse, and that was necessary. Obviously, Walt did that in the beginning, and it's cool to see that Wayne was able to do that for over three decades. So thanks to him, and we can all remember him. And then last up, in 2015, on May 18th, the Pixar animated film Inside Out premiered at the Cannes Film Festival, which was set to be released in the U.S. later in June 19th of the same year. So the story, if you haven't seen this movie, is of a young girl, Riley, where five emotions, joy, anger, disgust, fear, and sadness try to lead her through life. It's a great film. We saw this together as a family. Everyone in our family really loved it across the board. It was loved by many. I think a lot of people use this film to help their children actually express and understand their emotions. And I think it was even good for adults to learn how to label and understand their emotions and how they have a part in their lives at different times. And it's for a good reason. And learning to, you know, use our emotions at the right time or allow them to happen. You need a little sadness sometimes. You need joy sometimes. You need to be afraid sometimes, and sometimes you get angry, and that's okay. I really kind of like the character anger, because he's angry, but it's funny. And isn't it kind of funny sometimes when we're angry, especially around family, and we just get in our moods or whatnot? Anyway, it can be funny too. I don't know if you've ever been in an argument and then started laughing, because it's just, anger is kind of can be ridiculous, but it has a necessity in our lives as well. So did I cover all the, disgust. Yeah, I think we need a bit of disgust every once in a while. There are things that are just gross, and it's good we know it. Otherwise, we go around probably eating or walking in or living in filth or whatnot. So disgust is also a good thing to have at certain times, but not all the time. And we shouldn't have, and I liked how you see these different emotions, and it kind of shows how in certain settings it's not appropriate or it causes more problems for you. Like having disgust for, you know, people you're trying to love probably isn't the best. Like, we're trying to cultivate love and kindness, etc. It's a great film. And this was directed by Peter Docter. So he did Monsters Incorporated and also Up. Those movies I love. Up is so emotional. Inside Out, so emotional. What a great job. And then coming in 2020, I'm not really sure of when it will release to either Disney Plus or the theater. I'm not sure what they'll do, but is Soul. And that's sure to be really good. I just watched the preview again, and the preview trailer, and yeah, I started crying. It's definitely something that I think we'll all, when we see it, be pretty emotional. I'm pretty sure this is gonna be a great film also. So Peter Docter, what a great director. And I'm glad that he's given us these great films. I love Up 2 so much. We just watched that the other night. So anyway, Inside Out, oh my goodness, if you haven't seen it, go watch it. Great time to watch it right now with, aren't we experiencing lots of emotions and seeing them in our friends and family too. So good time to watch it. But I hope you guys, that's it for this day in Disney, and I hope you guys are having a great May 18th, and we'll see you next time.